I'm here with Rui's Revenge, a greyhound that my husband and I used to train. He was a great dog for us. He had 14 wins from 44 starts, but he's finished racing now and he's just arrived today at the Greyhound Adoption Program property here in Seymour. Rui, we're going to find you a new home. Larissa Darragh, you run the GAP property. How did you become involved?
I became involved about 15 years ago, Simone, because I love dogs and I wanted to do something that I felt that was important, that was helping something.
And what actually happens here at the property?
Yeah, what we do is we take dogs that are not suitable for racing anymore. So they're either too slow or they've just finished their racing career. We assess each dog, we put him into a foster home, we get him used to being a pet dog, and then we match him up with somebody waiting to adopt.
And that, I guess, is very important, matching him to the correct home.
It is. It's really important. So we're different to a normal shelter like the RSPCA, where you can walk along and pick a dog. With us, what we do is we have a look at what the person who's adopting, what sort of dog they need, and which of our dogs best matches that home.
Larissa, greyhounds arrive weekly here. How many do you have on the property?
We've got kennelling for 60 here. We're usually full, and we generally have another 40 or so out in foster care. So we usually have between 70 and 100 dogs at any one time going through the program.
And they make absolutely fantastic pets, don't they?
Yeah, they do. They're a very placid dog. They're a very low-energy dog. They're happy to spend most of the day lying around sleeping. So they're a fabulous pet.
So a pet doesn't really need much work at all?
No, that's exactly right. One of the major misconceptions about the breeds is that people think they're a high energy dog because they see them racing, but they don't realise that the races are over in 20 or 30 seconds. The dogs are really tired after that and they just want to go to sleep. So because they're a sprinter, they actually don't have any stamina, so they're happy to sleep all day.
The biggest misconception though about greyhounds is the fact that they're vicious because they wear muzzles, but
yeah,
it couldn't be further from the truth.
Exactly right. And if you ask any vets, they love working on the dogs because they're not likely to bite you. Our dogs don't have to be muzzled in public because they've been tested to be safe around other dogs, and so they get a special green collar like that dog's wearing there.
He's very well behaved.
He is. I know, he's sitting there very nicely. And so our dogs don't have to be muzzled in public.
Larissa, you've been doing this job for 16 years. Do you still have the same passion from when you started?
Oh, absolutely. I feel very blessed and I'm just so lucky to be able to do a job that I think it's important, it's making a difference. I get to see the dogs go off to their new homes, which is just a...
very rewarding, I'd imagine.
It is. It's really rewarding and just so lucky to do what I do.